Trishna. I work on the Ansible team as software engineer, and I'm Fedora project and Project Atomic contributor. So this talk is going to be about Ansible automation to custom your own ostree, that is to build your own atomic host. But this talk is not going to be about an introduction on an atomic host because Dusty already covered that thing. So let's get started. So let's have a look at the architecture of the composing of ostree. So it's client server architecture. So you have a set of RPMs that rpm-ostree then compose it, which happens in the server. Then you then we serve the repo, ostree repo, over a web server, and then the client consume it, that is the atomic host client consume it, and you have the your own custom atomic host. So please feel free to interrupt me if you have questions. So as based on the architecture, the requirements would be: I need a machine that to that would act as a server, that is going to host the compose the file system ostree, and I will need a web server to host my ostree repository, and the atomic host client that is going to compose the ostree and just configure it. So I'm going to use my Fedora workstation as the server that would going to host the ostree, and then you will need to install the requirements that is required to compose ostree, means rpm ostree package, ostree packages, and I will use atomic host VM that would act as client. So you will need all the camo image and libvirt for the VM purpose. Then, so for Fedora Atomic, they have a script on pacure.io. So that is used to build atomic host. And there is a CentOS atomic host repo for that as well. And in order to add your packages, since atomic host is immutable, you need to, if you want to add your own packages, you just added the manifest file there. There is a file named Fedora Atomic Docker, which is a JSON file. It has all the list of packages that Atomic Host is going to have. So suppose you want to add Vim, Tmux, or whatever, just go on adding the packages there. And then we are going to start the web server that is going to make the ostree available for the consumption of Atomic Host. And we will compose the ostree and create. I have downloaded an atomic qkauto image. So I'm going to create VM or run VM from it. That is going to act as client. And we will just rebase it, and so that atomic host can use that composed ostree. So these are the steps when you want to have your own custom ostree or own atomic host. So I just explained all the steps. The first step was my server machine and the requirements. So here is the atomic build script that Fedora Atomic has. So you will need to clone this repo that has the metadata and script to build the atomic host. And this is the file inside that repo which you have to edit in order to add packages. And for the web server, I have used simple HTTP server. I'm going to make it available on port 35,000. And there we compose the ostree using that manifest file. And the client VM I'll create. And after that, we are going to just rebase the ostree and make the atomic host using the new custom ostree. So these are lots of manual steps that you have to do if you want to build your own atomic host or create custom ostree. So I thought to just simplify my work. That is why I choose Ansible for that. So why Ansible? Because Ansible is agentless. So it is client-server architecture based. You do not need, and also you do not need to install any third-party packages on server or client in order to use Ansible. You just need to install Ansible and Python 2.7 right now. We are going to have Python 3.5 support as well later on few releases. And it's simple, it just uses YAML, that is yet another markup language, which is totally like English, so you do not need to spend time learning a new programming language. And it's powerful, even it is simple, it's powerful because if you know Fedora infrastructure applications, they use Ansible to maintain their applications and deploy their applications. So even though it's very simple, but it's very much powerful. And it's secured, it uses SSH to establish connection. So to use Ansible for this composing ostree, I'm going to show you the steps. That is here. So you will need to, first you'll need to download the Fedora Qkauto image from the getfedora.org website. Then then you have to git clone the repository and just make sure that you have Ansible installed on your host. And after you clone the repository and install Ansible, you will just need to run this playbook setup.yaml on your system. So what it is going to do, it is going to install the requirements on your system that I was talking about, like rpm-ostree, ostree packages, and the packages required to create VM from the Qkauto images, everything. It is also going to start the web server that you will require to serve the ostree, and some basic initializing ostree and field steps. So after it is done, you will need to find the IP address of the HTTP server you just served. So you can use ipaddr command for that. And after you have it, just put the IP address in the variable file atomic.yaml. So, and there is another variable file where you can add the packages you want to have. That is, so I wanted to have Vim enhanced and Git. So I added those packages in buildrepo.yaml. And there are a few other informations you need to add, that is to create VM from Qkauto image. So the client that I'm going to create, that you need to provide, I mean, how many CPU you want to give it, how much of memory, and the name of the image, that is whatever image you have downloaded. So after you are done with putting all this data in the variable file, just run the main YAML file, which is going to compose the ostree and start the atomic host client and make atomic host consume the new ostree. So that's all you are done with having your own custom ostree. Just reboot the, just SSH to the atomic host, and if you do RPM query, you will have all the new packages added there. So I have used cloud in it for adding the user ID and password for the VM I have created. So since right now it is atomic user and password atomic, so if you just go on building the repo, you will need to use the same username password, but you can edit this as well. Just go to the template file in the repo. There is a file where you can edit the user data. And so on this network, it took me a while to compose the ostree. That is why I have recorded the demo. I can play. Visible? It's not, I guess. Okay. I just run the setup YAML file. Now it is running the YAML file, which is installing the packages. And it started the HTTP server and to make the ostree available. Then I checked the IP address of the HTTP server and I just put on the IP address in the file. That is this one for me. And I'm not just going to run the main playbook right now. So it is just creating the VM from the Guha image right now. So you see all the steps here. It's and then it cloned the build script that is on Pegior. Then it added the packages in the JSON file, that is the manifest file in on that repo. And now it is composing the ostree. So on this network, it took me more than 1 hour to compose the ostree, so I'm going to skip it. It's still composing. So the compose is done, and now it is going to retrieve the IP of the VM, the atomic VM we have created. So this is the current IP. Now you just SSH to it. Now it is rebasing the ostree. It is going to take a minute. It's done. So if you want to check your atomic host VM's IP, you can use verj command as well. Now I just SSH to it and checking the rpm-ostree status. So if you look at the rpm-ostree status, it's not visible there. So there is a bullet sign beside Fedora Atomic here, which means the Atomic host is still using this ostree, but we right now have the new ostree composed. So in order to make the Atomic host use the custom ostree, we need to do reboot. So I tried to automate this with Ansible as well, but somehow it was successful, but it showed me an error message like timeout. So that's a bad thing in Ansible. We are still working on that thing. So after reboot, just you need to manually SSH again. Now I'm checking the status again, and it's not visible on the screen. So now, right now, the bullet sign is on my custom ostree, and I'm checking the packages that I have added in the manifest file, and you have all the packages on the atomic host. So that's it. If you want to look at the script, I have it on my slides, and so these are the requirements I have used in the playbook, and these were required in order to achieve this. And this is the setup YAML file. So here we are installing the requirements, and we are doing some basic setup for in order to serve that ostree repository. And then this is a file for creating VM. So in last DevCon, Jonathan wrote a script on this. It was a shell script, so I literally converted that into a playbook. So, and it became more readable to me. And the create VM script. It is included in the main playbook, so you do not have to care about, like, you have to run that playbook or what. So this is the main playbook where we have included the create VM and the compose ostree playbook. Now we are just doing some basic step for the SSH. After the compose and create VM create is done, we are just retrieving the IP of the atomic host VM that we have created and just copying the SSH key so that we can just go ahead and SSH to it, and then rebasing the ostree, and that's it. So in just for variables, you, in order to use this, you need to keep in mind that you add these variables, that is, this is the HTTP server IP address, and this is the workspace I have used in this. This is the place where you're going to, you want to have your atomic build script, that is, so I have cloned the Pegure at Fedora atomic script, that is this one, the repository, sorry. So when you add this directory here, it is going to clone that repository in this place. And then just add the packages you want to have in your new atomic host. And these are the details for the VM. So that's it. Here is the source and slide and blog post if you want to go ahead and read it. Any questions? Bug on this one? Okay, so there was a proposal on it, a while ago. On this, I guess, yeah. So, he wanted to do for bare metal provisioning support for this. So, I didn't get time to look into this. Actually, repeat the question? I didn't get it. Maybe not really. I mean, we can, so in Ansible, I think it would be best to, separate, keep it abstract via variable. Literally everything in playbook. So you can use the, you do not have to rewrite playbook all the time when you have different requirements. You just add your variables and just run the playbooks. I'm not looking into this issue actually right now, but I will maybe some weekend. Yep. Yeah, so actually what I did before, I wrote an Ansible module for the RPM ostree. But then we thought that maybe it would be useful to write Ansible module for client-side use. So actually we need to decide, from the Atomic community, like what kind of client-side module we want to add. So you mean the Atomic host client-side or RPM ostree commands, like adding packages or checking status, this kind of? Okay. Yeah, that would be great, right. So for that, maybe we can create an issue, create issues on Ansible as RFE. That would be useful to keep track. Anything else? let us know. Thank you so much.